Well, it's going to be a cold, cold morning. It's 40-something degrees, but with the wind, it's supposed to feel like it's 32. So it's freezing. It rained all night long. It's raining all morning until 9 a.m. or 10 a.m. Then it'll clear up. I expect the deer to be moving. It's Saturday morning. You got to get out and hunt.
What about that? Second day.
First deer kill in my life ever.
How does it feel?
It's interesting, man. I feel like it will feel a lot different when I get back at camp and I sit down and I process it. I feel like I just knocked a guy out and I'm running from the cops. I need to settle. I also haven't been hunting long enough to truly feel like, you know, I don't know, man. Like, you've done such a good job this weekend of putting people on deer that it's like, oh, well, must be easy to hunt in Vermont, right?
It's not easy at all. And you guys both got deer. It's insane, dude.
Oh, thank you.
What a unique rack, too.
Thank you.
Never seen a deer rack like that here at camp.
It's warm. It's fucking.
Yep.
Thank you, deer. We will consume you.
So awesome, Evan. Great job.
The only thing is, though, if,
You missed that first shot. That second follow-up shot was key.
I did miss the first one. I mean, I had nothing to aim at. I was just fucking... I said I knew there was a deer there, but... Fuck.
That's so awesome, Evan. Good job.
Thank you.
Well, I wasn't planning on getting up this morning at all. In fact, I'm still really exhausted from Vermont deer camp and taking Evan and Chris out and dragging deer up cliffs and things like that. And I was looking forward to sleeping in today, but... I'm getting sent pictures of one of my target bucks. I think it's my big one, so I gotta get out there.
Spot to be right now. Finally stopped snowing and it's dead calm. I just had a doe sneak up on me out here. I needed her to get into that spot right there and she didn't. She went that way. And I had three does cross there earlier. Back to where I was yesterday. It's really nice in here. I saw four does and then I called in a really big buck. I just did a grunt and a couple of canned calls and looked over my shoulder 5 minutes later and there was brown against the snow. It's pretty easy to pick up. And all I could see were antlers moving around and he went back and forth. Sniffing a track of one of the does I saw, but he never stepped into a shooting lane. He was only 25 yards away, but I couldn't shoot him. It's all this overhang, you know, you can see all this thick shit. It's like that all over the place, but I only only sat here for 3 hours yesterday and saw 5 deer, so. It's 20 degrees this morning. I've done a couple of calling sequences because, again, it's dead quiet, so. We'll see if I can get that big buck to come back in. That's all swamp over there, swamp. Swamp. Oak trees and a bunch of acorns. I just checked my cameras on the way in, and I mean, I always knew this place had a lot of buck sign. My dad said this was the place he's seen the most buck sign his entire life. But on the way in, I mean, I got maybe 12 or 14 different bucks in here. None of them were real, real small either, but none were real, real big. There's two big ones in here. And I know I've got a 10-pointer that wasn't on the camera this time, but that's in here as well. But even this morning, there were 2 bucks. Maybe 3 went right by here at 8 a.m. and then 10:30 a.m., so in daylight, you got chasing on there. And last time I sat here, I shot at one at last light and missed him. Just got some white hairs, went under him. I think it was like a good size 8-pointer. But I mean, I heard 2 bucks fighting last time I was here, and that was over a week ago. So, I think maybe the rattle will draw him in. We'll see. Check back with you later. Last night, I passed a doe that came through with us. I was chasing her, but I left the climber in the tree and easy peasy getting in here this morning. And it just turned shooting light. Same wind in my face. Hope I'm gonna catch up and slip it back into the swamp here. Party time, baby.
Let's see, that's somewhat fresh. Let's see if my camera's gonna have this buck on it. There's the camera on that tree. That's very fresh and huge. I hope it's got this monster on it. I wanna see what he looks like.
I see a lot. Yesterday I jumped a huge buck. Just going to check a camera on this new piece of property that I have permission on, but she wants me to hunt it next year, not this year, so I didn't bring my bow with me, and I I was walking into it. I put the camera up on a scrape like 10 days ago, and I was walking in, and I was thinking to myself, I wonder where they bed here, because it's pretty open. And I was just wondering because I'd never bumped any deer on the way in there to go check that camera. As soon as I thought that, when that entered my mind, this huge buck jumped off. He was only 20 yards away from me. Well, last night I was in here. There's fresh grapes everywhere, right down to the roots. I mean, big fresh grapes. There's one right behind me here. So I came in last night. I also have a really big buck on camera in here. That was recent, like the biggest buck I've ever seen on camera. Probably a 145 inch deer. Anyway, so I came in here last night, rattling every 20 minutes, with about a half hour shooting light, like right at sunset. Big buck was coming right where I wanted him, right down. The perfect spot I picked out. Trying to get into a 20 to 30 yard shooting lane. Like, I'm telling you, it was looking textbook. And then he, like they always seem to do, he didn't dig those lanes. He went behind a tree that I had at like 37 yards. And I didn't have any clear shooting lanes over there. But I'm anxious, and I took a bad shot. I put the 40-yard pin on him, and there were some small windows, but there were lots of sticks in the way, and it was a bad shot. I shouldn't have taken it, but he ran away with his tail tucked and ran away low and into the swamp, and I thought maybe I hit him. So I was sitting up in the tree waiting for, half hour. I take my release off with 5 minutes left. I take my arrow out. I bring up my bow rope. I tie it. And I start lowering my bow, and another buck comes in. But it's really getting hard to see at this point. And he starts making a scrape about 20 yards away from me, but I'm caught with my bow halfway down. He was a nice buck. He wasn't the big, big ones, but I would have shot him. And, yeah, that was that. I mean, if I had my bow ready to go and I still had my release on, I would have had that deer. He was only 20 yards away, and he was right in a perfect shooting lane. So, don't take your release off until legal is over, and keep your bow hanging. So, anyway, I couldn't find the arrow last night. I couldn't find blood, so buddy Chris helped out. We came back around 10 p.m. looked for it. Couldn't find anything, so backed out. I'm gonna look today, but I decided to come in and sit in the morning. And I just had two bucks around me. They were fighting with each other. Got some good footage of one buck got within 15 yards.
too small. I'm going to let him pass. Way too small. Look at this guy. Now I said you're too small. I'm going to let you pass. Didn't see anything?
What's that?
Didn't see anything?
Found a bunch of rocks and scrapes. Another tree stand, too.
I saw a tree stand way up at the top there.
By the edge of the edge of the swamp.
Yeah.
It looks like it's been there a while, though. Yeah. Unless the guy...